Hi, it's Ali Drew for BBTV. I'm here at Salford City Boxing Academy catching up with undefeated Savannah Marshall ahead of her next outing in Newcastle on the Matchroom Show on the 4th of April. So Savannah, already working hard in the gym, I've seen. Now you've got a fight date. Are you going to be stepping things up?
Yeah, so I was hoping to get out a bit earlier, but just the way things are, but looking at the positives, I've got a little bit more time. So I'm back out in April in Newcastle, where I'm from, the North East. So I'm really excited.
And your last fight was also in Newcastle. Yeah. Amazing atmosphere. Do you think that was a sort of recognition of how far you've come and also how far women's boxing has come, that you had such a great like support there?
Yeah, definitely. I think even at the weigh-in, the amount of support I got, I was like, is this for me? I'm still under the illusion that no one knows who I am. But there was another girl from the Northeast, April Hunter. She's a good friend of mine, so she was on as well, so it was good to share the experience with her.
And what was it actually like fight night, you know, in that arena? And what do you think it'll be the same next time you go back in April?
Well, I remember coming out the tunnel, like waiting to fight, and just the support threw me off of it. Even still then, I was like, he's here for me. But I'll be a little bit more, I know what's coming next time, so I think it'll be a bit more, I can soak it up a bit more.
And you did bump into your potential opponent, Clarissa Shields. What was that like?
I've got no bad blood with Clarissa.
Yeah, it didn't seem like it was.
No, but I was a bit gutted because I was wanting a bit of a. I psyched myself up for a bit of shoving and stuff like that. Maybe next time.
And did you see her last fight? Did you watch?
No, I've seen clips. Mm-hmm. But I knew what had happened anyway. I know I've seen that Croatian. I got offered the fight with her last year, and it was when I was in the process of moving to Matchroom, so it never come off. So I knew Clarissa would win unanimous anyway. But congratulations to her, 3-time world champion. She's made history, and fair play to her.
And do you think that she has improved? She's improving with every fight?
I think every fight's different with Clarissa. I'd still say that the best I've seen of Clarissa is when she boxed Hammer and she done what she needed to do. But like I said, you can only box who's put in front of you, and she done what she needed to do to beat the Croatian.
Because obviously you are the only person to ever defeat, obviously, as an amateur. So do you think she's improving every fight? And also, do you think since then as well, you're improving every fight?
Yeah, I think we're both completely different boxers to when we fought last. I was the typical amateur, upright, hands up here. Now I'm just totally different. I'm not even that girl anymore. So, and she's changed as well, so I think it'll be a totally different fight. Same outcome.
And how are you finding working with Eddie Hearn and also Matchrooms? How are you finding the Matchroom
system? I love it. I think for me it was the best move for me because Eddie's got the shows and he's got he gets the views. So for me, especially being a female, it's the best platform, really.
And so do you think that maybe this year coming up is going to be the time when the world title comes to the table?
I hope so. So I've had 8 fights now, and I believe that I'm banging on world title level, but it's just, boxing's a bit of business and it's very political. I've been mandatory for the WBA for 18 months now, so I'm hoping to get a little bit of movement in that direction. So just fingers crossed it comes off.
And are you thinking potentially this year, or do you not have a sort of dates in mind?
Yeah, definitely potentially this year. I'm 28 now, I'm not getting any younger, and I don't want to be one of them people in the sport till you're like late 30s, so I want it all now.
And so are you still living with Chantal?
How's that going? I flat share with Chantal. Sometimes I want to strangle her. But nah, I've been good friends with Chantal since we were 18. We were on Team GB together. Mm-hmm. So, and because we're in the same sport, we're going through the same thing. So one minute we hate boxing, the next minute it's the best thing since sliced bread.
Will you let us come and do like a crib style interview with you there? Will you let us do that?
I'll have to blitz the house because she doesn't clean. Give me a bit of notice.
We'll tell you when we're coming. So with obviously women's boxing is getting bigger, what piece of advice would you give sort of an up and coming female boxer? What one piece of advice would you say to help them sort of get successful?
You've just got to enjoy it. Like I said, there's times I've been boxing now for since I was 12, 16 years I've been boxing, and there's been times when I've hated life and I've wanted to retire and wrap in and have nothing to do with the sport, but I enjoy it more than, there's more good days and bad days, so you've just got to enjoy it. And I love training. What's the point of doing it if you don't enjoy it?
And so what have you got planned today? You've got some crazy stuff set up over there.
So we trained this morning with Pete Clark, who does all of our like fitness side, strength side. So I think we've got a bit of, what is it this morning?
It's boxing, fitness, speed and agility.
Looks like some sort of slalom.
That means health. Well, translates to health.
We'll let you get on with that, but thanks for joining us and good luck for your fight in April.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks.